Now, the first question is that at what time, the hands will be together, the both hands of the clock will be together between 2 o'clock and 3 o'clock. Now, this is the question, that at what time the clock hands will be together between 2 o'clock and 3 o'clock. So, let's quickly start with our position. Let's say, you know, the minimum time is 2 o'clock, maximum is 3 o'clock. Between the window of 2 and 3, they have to be together. So, at 2 o'clock, let's start with, you know, this is 12, this is 1, this is 2. So, at 2 o'clock, the position will be something like this. You know, ignore this part now. The position will be something like this, fine. So, the minute-wise distance, is how much? The minute-wise distance is 10 minutes. Right, the minute-wise distance is how much? 10 minutes, not a problem. Now we know that if it becomes an hour, now first of all, you know, you need to use your own common sense and find out whether they will be crossing or not. So always remember that in every hour, the minute and the hour hand, they cross once, just once in every hour. It doesn't happen that they cross twice. It doesn't happen that they do not cross at all. So they will definitely cross. This is something we are aware of. Now let's see. You know, in 60 minutes, now to begin with, they are how far away? You know, you can do this in terms of angle as well, right? Or you can do this in terms of minutes. Since minutes calculation is you know, slightly easier, so we are doing it in terms of minutes. So let's say they are, how far away they are? They are 10 minutes away, right? And if an hour passes, in an hour, and you know, the minute hand is behind and the hour hand is ahead. So, in when they will be together, let's say, you know, they will be together when, you know, suppose they travel a distance x, you know, I'm just giving, will not use this x, it is not required. I'm just giving you an example. Let's say they travel a, the hour hand travels a distance x, and at this point they meet. Now, the hour hand has traveled how much distance x? The minute hand has traveled how much distance? 10 plus x, right? That means the minute x, the minute hand, has to travel 10 minutes more than our hand. If there is a common difference, you know, a common distance of 10 minutes between the two hands, then to be together, the minute hand has to, you know, catch up with the, with those 10 minutes distance. And we know now, you know, this fact I asked you to remember, that it covers a 55 minute, you know, it leads, it covers 55 minutes more than the hour's hand in 1 hour. So, you know, a lead of 55 minutes can be obtained in how much? 1 hour. So, a lead of 1 minute can be obtained in how much? Let's call 1 hour as 60 minutes to, for our ease. 60 upon 55 minutes, right? And a lead of 10 minutes. That is the only lead we want in this question, can be obtained is 60, I'm sorry, by 55 into 10. We can find this out. This becomes 600 by, or, you know, let's divide this, 2 and 11. If this becomes 120 by 11. So, that becomes 10 and 10 by 11 minutes. So, 10, so you know, 10 and 10 by 11 minutes, later they will meet. So, let's, you know, convert it into decimal. This will be 10.9 almost minutes. So, they will meet at what time? They started at 2, so they will meet at 2. 10.9. When it is almost 2:11, then they will be together. At that point, they will be together. So, this is the first kind of question, very, very simple. The questions majorly will be of this nature. Now, let's say, you know, in this question, or, you know, let's take a different question and let's try to find out that if there could be, you know, other options there as well or not. Let's say, you know, the question can ask you that maybe, you know, the clock starts at 4 o'clock, right? The clock starts at 4. Maybe I'll draw a different diagram and, you know, will be, that will be much neater to explain.